Students, in this problem, it's given Mango Limited wants to acquire Apple and swap ratio agreed is 1:2, that is 0.5 shares for 0.5 shares of Mango for 1 share of Apple. Okay, and they are given profit after tax, Mango 18 lakhs, Apple 3,60,000. Please go through the question. Then equity shares, number of shares outstanding 6 lakhs and 1,80,000. EPS 3 for Mango, 2 for Apple. PE ratio 10 for Mango, 7 for Apple. Market price 30 for Mango and Apple, 40. So the questions are, number of equity shares to be issued by Mango for acquisition of Apple Limited. Okay, number of equity shares to be issued by Mango for, see they have already given you the swap ratio, okay, which is 1:2. Hence, here we are having Apple Limited 1,80,000 shares, okay. So it will be 90,000. Anyway, I will write it. For the first question, number of shares to be issued by Mango. Number of shares to be issued by Mango to Apple. So the exchange ratio is 0.5. Okay. Exchange ratio is 0.5. Existing number of shares. Existing shares of Apple equals 1,80,000. So new shares will be existing shares 1,80,000 multiplied by the exchange ratio 0.5, that will be 90,000. 90,000 shares will have to be issued to Apple company shareholders by the Mango company shareholders. Okay. And the second question is, what is the EPS of Mango Limited after the acquisition? Okay. For this, we need to post merger earnings divided by the number of shares will give you the EPS of Mango after acquisition. So for the second question, post merger Mango EPS. That would be post merger earnings divided by post merger number of shares. So post merger earnings will be, for Mango it is 80 lakhs given in the problem, plus 3,60,000 for Apple, divide by existing shares of Mango is 6 lakhs and new shares issued we have calculated, which is 90,000. So this will give you 3.13. 3.13 is the EPS post merger for the Mango, because after merger Apple will also become Mango. So Mango post merger EPS is 3.13. And the third question is, determine the equivalent earnings per share of Apple Limited. So the third question is, equivalent EPS of Apple post merger, that will be, see, 3.13 is the total company's EPS, whereas Apple shareholders get half share for one share of Apple, half share of Mango they get for one share of Apple. So the EPS will be half multiplied by half. This will be 1.57. Okay. So 1.57 is the equivalent EPS of Apple Limited, right? And the fourth question is, what is the expected market price per share of Mango Limited after the acquisition, assuming its PE remains unchanged? So after the acquisition, what will be the market price? So for that, we know the earnings per share, and the PE ratio was 10 for bigger company, that is Mango. Okay. So the fourth question is, pre-merger PE ratio for Mango equals 10. Okay. Post-merger EPS, we have calculated earlier, it is 3.13. Okay, and we know market price is PE into earnings per share. See, PE ratio they have already given. In the beginning it is 10. So you take the 10 into 3.13, that would be 31.3. 31.3 is the share price of post-merger company, that is Mango Limited. And the next question is, finally, they have asked for market value of the merger firm or market capitalization of merger firm. What is market capitalization? It is the multiplication of number of shares into share price. We found out share price and we know what is the number of shares. Share price, okay. So market value is share price into number of shares. We have calculated share price as 31.3 multiplied by the number of shares which I have already found out, that is 6 lakhs of Mango plus additional 90,000 given for Apple. So 6,90,000, that would be 2,15,97,000. 2,15,97,000. This is the market value of the new company. Thank you.